We have many prayers of thanksgiving in the Jewish tradition, as do, I'm sure, all of your traditions. We have prayers of thanksgiving in the morning prayers, in the evening prayers, Friday night prayers, Saturday morning prayers, before we eat, when we see a rainbow, and on and on and on. And we have a fall festival of Thanksgiving. But the biggest Thanksgiving of all is our Passover celebration, which comes in the spring, which commemorates the Jews being able to leave Egypt and gain their freedom. And that is celebrated with a Seder, which is a big dinner, like Thanksgiving dinner. I always say Thanksgiving and the Seder are my favorite holidays because I don't have to figure out what to cook. You know exactly what you have to make. And the Seder is like that too. But the Seder is accompanied by a service, which is in a book called Haggadah. And I'm going to read a poem of Thanksgiving from this version of the Haggadah. Were our mouths as full of songs as the sea, and our tongues with melody as a multitude of waves, our lips with praises as vast as the sky, our eyes shining like the sun and the moon, our arms spread like soaring eagles, our legs as light as gazelles, we would not be able to thank you sufficiently, our God and God of our ancestors, and praise your name for the goodness beyond measure you have granted our ancestors and us. Now and forever, to you alone we give thanks.
When we gather together as people of different faiths and come together as an interfaith gathering, we also come together as friends. And I think that's an important part. And I offer to us tonight a Thanksgiving garden litany written by one of my late Unitarian Universalist colleagues, the Reverend Max Coutts. I will read the one voice and invite you to respond with the response that says all. For generous friends, with hearts and smiles as bright as their blossoms. For feisty friends, as tart as apples. For continuous friends, who like scallions and cucumbers, keep reminding us that we've had them. For crotchety friends, as sour as rhubarb and as indestructible. For handsome friends, who are as gorgeous as eggplant and as elegant as a row of corn. And for others, as plain as potatoes, and so good for you.
Let us give thanks.
For funny friends, who are as silly as Brussels sprouts, and as amusing as Jerusalem artichokes. And serious friends, as complex as cauliflower, and as intricate as onions. For friends as unpretentious as cabbages, and some as summer squash, as persistent as parsley, as delightful as dill, as endless as zucchini, and who, like parsnip, can be counted on to see you through the winter.
Let us give thanks.
For old friends, nodding like sunflowers in the evening time, and young friends coming on as fast as radishes, and for loving friends, who wind around us like tendrils and hold us despite our blights, wilts, and witherings. And finally, for those friends now gone, like gardens past that have been harvested, but who fed us in their times that we might have life hereafter.
Let us give thanks.
Let us give thanks for a bounty of people, for children, who are our second planting. And though they grow like weeds and the wind too soon blows them away, may they forgive us our cultivation and fondly remember where their roots are.
For all these, we give thanks.